Welcome to r/survivinginfidelity. Here are a couple more stories. Story number 1. He confessed to being in love with her. I'm 7 months pregnant with our planned and much wanted baby. He left me originally about 3 months ago, saying he has suddenly lost feelings for me and didn't know why. I felt there was someone else because his reasons made no sense. He insisted there wasn't. He only did this once. He started a new job a few weeks before. So, I suspected one of the younger girls he worked with, but had no proof. He kept popping back up every so often to check on me and the baby, and would say he missed me and still loved me, but didn't felt weird and was missing feelings, etc. He came to visit me once, and I could tell his affection was gone. I always asked him to please tell me the truth so I could put my head to rest and move in. Always insisted no. I kept an eye on this girl's social media account and his, and my suspicions grew. Eventually he told me he had developed feelings for someone else, but hadn't acted on them. He said he had confessed them to her, but she told him that she didn't want to get in between him and me, and that we were having a baby together. She is 24. I was heartbroken, and he promised he wouldn't see her anymore. Even though he worked with her, he didn't keep to this, and I found out she had been to his flat, and he had been hanging out. I got upset. He understood why I was upset, told me he wanted to try and make things better with us and be a family, said he just wanted me to stop hurting and be happy. He said maybe his feelings will come back with time for me. I feel awful when he says that. We had a long chat, and he finally admitted that he lost his feelings because he fell in love with her. He admitted that if we weren't together, that she would want to be with him, even though she hasn't told him that. He just knows. I can see he is only staying with me because I'm so heartbroken, and a baby is on the way. He feels guilty. I feel weak and mentally unstable from all this upset and stress. It keeps going through my mind. He's 38. She's 24. I can't compete with a 24-year-old. I'm 37. But for him to fall for her so fast, a few weeks after starting at his new job, it hurts knowing he sees her at work every day. He says he can't quit yet cause COVID, and he won't find a new job that easily. All excuses in my mind. He barely calls or texts me. When he does, he's nice, but quiet, and there is no connection from him. It's all obligation. And so I hurt when I hear from him, and hurt when I don't. He says he wants to try and fix us, but there is no fight in him. I told him I want to fall out of love with him, but didn't know how. He said the best way is to cut all contact and social media, like he was giving me advice. I asked if that's what I should do. He said if I think it will help me feel better. I told him that perhaps it should be him cutting all contact with her, so he can fall out of love with her, and he can concentrate on his family. He sighed irritably and just said, yeah, whatever, let's discuss it tomorrow. I can see I need to let him go. His heart is not with me or his unborn baby. I felt he should be fighting for us, but he doesn't. He's like someone else. I know I need to be strong and cut him off. My baby arrives in 2 months. I wanted the man I love more than anything to be by my side while I welcomed our baby into the world, but I can't face this guy being there as he's like a stranger. If I cut him off now, I can't have him there adding to my stress. Please, can you guys help encourage me that I'm doing the right thing? Please. I'm so heartbroken. Edit. Thanks everyone. I didn't sleep a wink last night and saw all these lovely supportive messages on my phone from you lovely lot this morning. Part of me wonders if I should message this girl, letting her know she is the reason he abandoned me and his unborn baby. Cause he told me she thought we were already broken up and doesn't know she is the reason. I keep looking for a reason not to, but he's already destroyed our little family. So why should he start afresh on lies with her? Here's the first comment. It sucks, but do yourself a favor and end it. He's too cowardice to do it, so he's doing everything possible for you to do it, so he can pursue this girl that's nearly half his age. He doesn't have a backbone. You said it yourself. You're reading him, and he doesn't seem to be doing this out of the genuine care for you or the child. I know you want him there for what he used to be, but what you're more than likely going to get is a moment that should have been magical, marred by his resentment for you and this child. and this disingenuous act to want to make this work. Here's the next comment. You said, I can't compete with a 24-year-old. Terrible mindset. Girl. He cheated because he is a scumbag. Even Beyoncé was cheated on. It has nothing to do with competition. He's just a sleaze. Make his ass pay child support. And start leaning on your support system. You'll get through this. But damn. He's a piece of crap. Here's the next comment. Don't let him be in the delivery room. Pick your mother. Or a friend. He doesn't deserve that right. I know you're a hormonal mess. But let him go. Ask him to move out. Start the painful process of separating now before the child is born. You know it's impossible to be a happy family now. It's not fair to you. Having him around makes things worse. You need separation from him. He can have the 24-year-old. It'll flame out soon enough due to the age gap and difference in life experiences. Definitely do not move to his country. That would end in disaster. Stay where you are and raise the baby there. Get back to no contact. You can inform him after the baby is delivered. Here's the next comment. He might be in for a fall. It's been apparent to DH and me that our 21-year-old daughter's 34-year-old boss of 6 months has inappropriate feelings for her. Despite a partner and 1-year-old child, now her co-workers have realized too. She cannot stand him. She finds him creepy and sad. She's now decided to be as rude and unfriendly as possible. Sad men and their feelings for very young women. I hope he falls on his face. Here's the next comment. I need to throw my 2 cents in. I'm a 24-year-old. And let me freaking tell you. Ain't nothing special about this age. If she had any decency, she would not be entertaining that man. She knows exactly what she's doing. If she does actually get him, it's not going to be what she's expecting. And my guess is that she'll quickly move on. You think she wants to be a stepmom right off the bat? No way. You and that baby are the prize. Also, after I had my first baby 4 years ago, split from pathetic dad, I found somebody else and guess what? We are going on 3 years strong. And he loves my daughter like his own. And he loves me. Maybe your true love is literally just waiting for you and little baby to walk into his life. Girl, I'm literally rooting for you. Story number 2. My ex-wife's husband, the one she cheated with, wants to be friends now. So, my wife cheated on me about 4 to 5 years ago and ended up marrying the guy. I'm actually pretty far removed from the situation. I've been through all sorts of therapy and I'm remarried. Randomly, the man she cheated with called me, which is weird because the last time I talked to him was years ago and ended with me threatening to beat him up. I was angry, okay. So, he starts breaking down crying and apologizing to me. He then tells me that my ex-wife is doing the same exact thing to him that she did to me. No surprise there. He says now he understands what I went through and the pain he caused me. He then asked if we could hang out and get a beer. This whole thing is just too weird for me. I just used being in quarantine as an excuse because I did kind of feel bad for him. But he keeps messaging me trying to start a conversation with me, but I don't really respond. It just brings up old memories and trauma that I haven't had in a while. My wife is also opposed to me talking to him because she says, all you guys are going to do is talk about her. How do I handle this situation? I'm not a spiteful person who likes to kick someone while they're down, even if they deserve it. So I feel bad not helping him out. Because she's doing what she did with me, by slandering me to all my friends with lies, to make them take her side. So, he's alone, and has no one to talk to. Edit, I should clarify I have no interest in being his friend, and I'm not even considering it. This is purely just a rant. I even showed my wife this post. She's actually enjoying watching this train wreck unfold in their lives, lol. But I appreciate the concern. I'm going to block him. Was just venting that I felt bad. Here's the first comment. You don't want to kick him when he is down. Well, that is good of you, but you don't have to be his friend. Your wife is right. Here's the next comment. I have a good one for you. Oh, it's going to be epic. Tell him you are down to meet and have a few beers. providing he will invite the new lover of your ex, so you can form a club. If he has no problem bonding with the guy his wife cheated with, then you won't have a problem bonding with the guy your ex cheated with. Here's the next comment. Be honest. Let him know you don't want to be his friend. You feel bad for him. But you can't be his emotional support, because you're still upset for what he did. Tell him you will be blocking him, and then block him. Easy peasy. Here's the next comment. Like the old adage goes, the enemy of enemy is my friend. Well, sort of. Honestly, not your monkey, not your circus. Tell him what you had to go through to get over him, and wish him luck. Here's the next comment. Listen to your wife. Nothing of value can be gained from hanging with this guy. He knew you were married, and still willfully had an affair, and married that cesspit. He is the one who needs to make peace with himself. Sometimes people do need to do some emotional jail time, and take a very long, very deep look at themselves. It's the only way they will grow as a person. Consider yourself blessed. You found yourself a new life with a new wife, who cares about you. Focus on her, and leave the past behind where it belongs. Send him this. I'm sorry you are going through this, and I hope you manage to pull through. But meeting you would only open old wounds I wish to remain buried. Thanks for listening.